In this video, I'm going to share with you 8 of my very best tips to help you get rid of erectile dysfunction so you can maintain a stronger and harder erection. So what we're waiting for, let's begin. Straight on to tip number 1, exercise equals a stronger erection, okay? And I'm going to tell you something even better than that. Here's something we could all do from today, okay? Go for a walk. Go for a walk every single day, just 30 minutes, okay? It's going to be so good for you. It's going to make you feel better. It's going to help improve your cardiovascular health. But not only that, it's going to reduce your risk of erectile dysfunction by 41%. That is massive, okay, just by walking. And if you can do some moderate intensity activity, for example, cycling, running, you know, going to the gym, anything like that, that can actually help restore sexual function as well, especially if you're overweight. So exercise equals stronger erection. It's as simple as that. And it's the easiest thing we can all do without having to take medication or treatment for erectile dysfunction. So in a nutshell, what's going to happen here, just by doing this, it's going to improve our cardiovascular health. But not only that, we're going to get some boost of testosterone. We're also going to get a boost of nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is basically one of the components that's required for that ignition that's going to cause us to have an erection, okay? So by doing these, we're getting a natural boost of nitric oxide and testosterone and the improvement of cardiovascular health, which is all going to help us have a stronger and maintain a harder erection for longer. Tip number 2, Kegel exercises. It's all about strengthening your pelvic floor muscles. Studies have shown that regular Kegel exercises can help strengthen your erection so you can maintain a stronger erection for longer. This is especially when done in combination with lifestyle changes that I'm going to discuss later on in this video. So definitely do watch them too. And combine them with these Kegel exercises, really. I will leave links to some exercises as well in the description, so definitely do check them out. Straight on to tip number 3, let's talk about some prescribed medication. This is something that's not often discussed, so I always like to make patients aware of it, so I'm going to discuss it in this video as well. There's 3 meds I want to talk about: thiazides, which are a type of diuretic, beta blockers, and serotonin reuptake inhibitors, known as SSRIs for short. These can sometimes make erectile dysfunction worse, okay? So if you are taking any of these medicines, or if you're prescribed any of these medicines, definitely do not stop them, but definitely have that conversation with your medical provider about them and see if there has been any correlation at all since starting them. Maybe you started them a few months ago and this happened, or maybe you started it years ago and this hasn't really impacted it. But you need to have a conversation with them so they can sort of see if it is a cause, and if it's not, and if it is, then they might prescribe an alternative for you. Straight on to tip number 4, watch your diet, okay? A study from the Massachusetts Male Aging Study basically showed that having a diet full of whole foods like fruits, vegetables, whole grains, fish, all these things that are healthy and unprocessed basically can help with erectile dysfunction. So you need to get rid of the processed foods, anything like that with a barcode on it basically that's processed and made, try and get rid of it. And instead opt for whole healthy foods. This is going to have a major impact in helping improve erectile dysfunction. And here's a bonus tip number 5, we need to trim our waistline. If you've got a waistline of 42 inches or more, you're 50% more likely to have erectile dysfunction compared to someone with a waistline of 32 inches, okay? So you really need to try and lose some weight if you have a larger waistline. Losing weight as well is going to help with other conditions as well, especially if you're diabetic or you're pre-diabetic or you have high cholesterol, if you have high blood pressure, all of which make erectile dysfunction worse. And if you are someone who struggles to lose weight, especially around the waist area, then definitely do watch my very own diet. It's called the Abraham Diet. Every week you can lose about 1 to 2 pounds following this diet. It's very simple and effective. It's been watched by over 25 million people worldwide, so I will leave a link to it in the description. Definitely do check it out. And straight on to tip number 6, erectile dysfunction treatment. So the most common that you've probably heard of, sildenafil, also known as Viagra, or Tadalafil, also known as Cialis. These are really effective at helping with erectile dysfunction. It is important that you take them properly. Of course, you need to speak to your medical provider. They will have to be prescribed. But it's probably 3 things that are really important if you do take them. First of all, take them 30 to 60 minutes before your anticipated sexual activity. Secondly, take them on an empty stomach so they absorb better. They'll be far more effective then. And thirdly, avoid alcohol when you're taking these. Alcohol is a suppressant. It's just going to make things worse. If you do want more information on how to take these properly for maximum, you know, benefit and maximum absorption, so they're most effective, I do have videos going through them in a lot of detail. So definitely check them out on the channel. So next up, have you ever heard of a vacuum erection device, also known as a penis pump? This here is a water-based vacuum pump class 2 medical device made here in England by a company called VaxAid. It's best used in the shower or in the bath so you can avoid the use of messy lubricants. It also has this really helpful hand pump, which basically makes it super easy for you to achieve maximum safe body pressure. VaxAid does offer a 100% full refund within 60 days, 2 years warranty, and free shipping worldwide. The team at VaxAid are very good friends of the channel, and to learn more about their fantastic products, I will leave a link in the description below. VaxAid, thank you for being our trusted sponsor. Straight on to tip number 7, be wary of supplements, guys. These are unregulated. Nobody really knows what's in them because there's no regulation. So they could say there's X, Y, Z in there, but it might not even be in there, okay? So they're massively unregulated. You don't know what you're taking. They can bring on side effects and problems as well. And there's no evidence that any of them actually help with erectile dysfunction. So my advice, stay away from them. Straight on to tip number 8, you need to speak to your provider and address underlying issues that might be causing the erectile dysfunction. Remember, about 50% of diabetics get erectile dysfunction. If you've got high blood pressure, if you've got high cholesterol, if you're not doing much exercise, if you smoke, all of these can contribute to erectile dysfunction. So if any of these apply to you, speak to your medical provider and get these underlying problems addressed. Now, it is really important to remember, if you have erectile dysfunction or if you have any concerns, you should always speak to your medical provider. That's so they can examine you, do some tests, make sure it's nothing else that's causing it, because sometimes there can be other causes. I really hope that this mixture of lifestyle tips, treatments, and everything that we've discussed in this video is helpful for you. And as always, sending awesome vibes.